We are going to be working with Microsoft Azure today and using their AI APIs. We're actually going to use their APIs to upgrade our chat translator. We're going to actually learn together. And so we should be pretty excited. Oh my goodness. What? Fritz, holy moly. Wow. 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 Big thanks to Microsoft Azure. They're sponsoring today's stream. This is our very first sponsored stream ever. We can try out their translator APIs, and it uses natural language, machine learning. They really told us to check out the API, and then at the end of the stream, after we try it out and use it, then to give honest feedback about like what we thought about it. I think the translations are gonna be really, really good. At the very least, it's gonna be way better than what we have now. Right now, if you guys know any other foreign languages, you can actually just type it in chat and it'll translate it for you. But sometimes it messes up. It's not very good because right now it uses a different API. When we switch it over to translate using the Azure API, I think it's gonna do way better. I got everything pretty much set up, but I only looked at the documentation. I haven't actually used it yet. And so this is gonna be my very first time using these AI APIs. Let's get started. Here is how to sign up for the Translator Text API. So we have a link in here. If you do exclamation Azure, we're using the Azure Cognitive Services documentation. That basically refers to anything that's like text analysis, like you can do sentiment analysis, you can do all sorts of things on Azure, and I'm kind of excited to try all of these. There's cognitive services with language support, data model requirements, you can do like computer vision. There's even a face API if you want to do like facial recognition. There's ink recognizer so that you can recognize like handwritings, form recognizer, custom vision service, video indexer so you can index videos, speech services, these are what we're going to be using today, translator, there's language APIs, Q&A maker, question and answer maker. Whoa, I want to try that. Guys, we can make a Q&A maker? That's really cool. Is it automatic answers or is it like an FAQ? I don't know. You could ask the Azure team, or you could even try it out. It's a cloud-based API that creates a conversational question and answer layer over your data. It answers your users' natural language questions by matching it with the best possible answer. Whoa. And you can build a bot in minutes. Immersive Reader. What is Immersive Reader? It's a tool that implements proven techniques to improve reading comprehension for emerging readers. Whoa. This is the one that I'm excited about. This is anomaly detector. Could you imagine if we could detect people in here as our anomaly, our content moderator? These seem like perfect fits for Twitch chat and stuff. I think these are really neat, the decision APIs. This is what we're gonna be using. We're using the Azure Cognitive Services documentation. We're gonna try out the language text translator API. I'm gonna get Chatterbox Translator Bot, which is our chat translator open source. This is on our GitHub, by the way. If you guys wanna actually see the code to most of our projects, they're all open source on our GitHub. So you can check it out, you can learn from it, you can expand it, you can add modifications to it and submit pull requests, and then we'll put it in and then it'll improve it. That's the whole point of open source. It's amazing. If you guys are interested, this is what the Microsoft Azure thing looks like. You have to sign up for the Translator Text API, sign into the Azure portal, you can create a free account. And if you create a free account, apparently you can get $200 worth of Azure credits for entirely free for like 30 days. And so you can use all of these AI APIs. $200, that's a lot. You can do a lot with it. And they just create resource and search the marketplace. You can be like translator text. And so that's what I did. I was like, create resource. And then I said, translate. And then you have translator text. And then you just create, and then it'll create it for you. And I actually have that up and running. This is what we're gonna do. We're gonna create a new version of this function. We're gonna say translate message with Azure. Then we go here and we're like subscription key. We go process.m.azure key. Up here, we'll say translate message with Azure. Let's type in exclamation point join. Okay, so now if we do Bluehost queso, then here we go, check it out. So it detected the language as language Espanol, score 1. That's pretty good. It knows that it's Spanish already. So it's got translations, here's the detected language. It's got the first one, it's detected, and the text is owl cheese. All right, that's so easy. Holy cram. So all I have to do is do and then 0.txt. Is that right? Wow. Oh dang. All right, so now we do that and then connected. Check this out, Bluehost queso, which means owl cheese. Oh, check it out. Chat translator is working. It was really, really easy. We basically just did this. We like copy pasted the sample code from here and then reformatted our code a little bit so that it would understand the return format of the Azure's API. And that was it. And then it works. It works. Oh my gosh. Lily, it translated your lol. That's so funny. Uh-oh. That's not good. I think Twitch chat broke, guys. I'm so sorry if you can't chat.
Oh my god.
It's not getting the messages at all. Oh dear.
We're breaking it, Sparky.
It's not getting my message. Oh, I finally got it. Okay. How's the experience been with Azure? It's been really nice. So basically, all we had to do so far for changing our translation API for our chat translator on our Twitch chat was to literally go to translate.js, and then we copy-pasted the sample code from this link, and then change the to language and the text, and then put it into our request here, and then reformat the result to match our format that we were reading out of. And that was it. We did it so fast that I was like, oh wow. Now we're gonna try the speech recognition and the cognitive services stuff. And hopefully I can get what I'm saying translated into another language and show that on stream. So that's what we're working on next. And to do that, it looks like what we had to do was to download this SDK, and now we're creating it. All of this code is gonna be in this repository here too. Most of our projects are all open sourced on GitHub, and so you can always check it out there too. All right, let's try this. Start recognition. Allow. Oh. Undefined reason. Okay, so maybe we have to set the region like this. Unable to contact server. It might be that I need a different subscription key. So I'm gonna try a different key. So here it is again. Let's try it. Testing. Does this work? That was it. Oh my gosh. Look at this. It's working, guys. We can recognize all the text. This is awesome. I wonder if I can make it so that we don't have to actually click the button anymore. I can do it where it just recognizes anytime I'm saying something. Oh, we have to use add target language. That's why. So we have to do add target language. And then we add it like that. Testing. Does this work? That's not in German. Wait a minute. Okay, we got it. So now, let's try this. Come in. What should I say? Webcraft, you're so awesome for following the channel. Here, let me give you some fluff points. And I don't know if it translated it right. Let's see if we can translate it back. Wow! This is amazing. It translates it back and back again. And holy moly. Hey, Sherman. Tell us a joke.
When you have a bladder infection, you're in trouble.
You're in trouble.
It took me so long. Oh my goodness. It's doing it.
Okay, what if we translate it from Spanish to English? Hola, señor. ¿Cómo estás?
Is this amazing or what?
Okay. Hola. Buenos días. Buenas tardes. Bienvenido. ¿Dónde está el baño? We can do French. C'est la vie en rose. Life in pink. This is amazing. Friday. Gotta get down on Friday. I'm gonna change it to French. Say something in English, now it's gonna translate it into French. We're past our time. Oh my gosh, that's okay. We did a lot today. Look at this. I can speak in German and have it translate. Well, I'm talking in English and then it gets translated in real time to German. I'm gonna try French again. And then we will wrap up stream there. But what did you guys think? Do you guys like Azure so far? I like it a lot. I think we might use more of these APIs. Oh, there's a link. You can click that link and check it out. Let's do one final vote. You can type in yes if you would like to try Azure. Type in no if it's not for you. Let's see. Holy moly. 12 people. It's unanimous. Everyone wants to try it. I'm so glad. Oh my gosh. All right, let's see who else.